What up, y'all? It's your guy, Dawson, from D&D TV. Thank you for rating, commenting, and subscribing. Everybody who's donated, those of you all who will, you know I appreciate it. All that information is in the description box below. Also, go over to my other YouTube channel, Dawson Speaks TV. Make sure you subscribe over there. Now, let's get into this topic. All right, y'all. Thanks for clicking on the video. Hope everyone is doing well. Thank you again to everybody who supports both channels. I am very appreciative to have these platforms and for you all to watch these videos. And those who donate, y'all be showing out in the donations. I appreciate it. I really do. Now, this story is coming out of Belle Glade, Florida. Yes, Belle Glade, not Belle Glade. Some people say Glades with an S. It's just Belle Glade. Belle Glade is a city in Palm Beach County, Florida, on the southern eastern shore of Lake Okeechobee. According to the 2010 U.S. Census, the city had a population of 17,467 people. For a time during the early to mid-1980s, the city had the highest rate of HIV/AIDS infection in the United States of America, and it continues to see an alarming rate of HIV infection since then, which is why I want to talk about this particular story. Two men from Belle Glade are accused of having sex with a teen without disclosing their HIV status. Vonkevious Moore, 28 years old, and Henry Green, 43, are facing charges of lewd and lascivious battery on a victim between the ages of 12 and 16 years old, and a charge of an HIV-infected person having sex without informing their partner. According to the arrest report, the 17-year-old boy told the sheriff's office in October 2000 about the sexual relationship he had with the two men, which began 2 years earlier when he was 15 years old. The teen told officers that he met Vonkevious Moore on a social media app, Grindr and Jack. They agreed to meet up for sex. The teen said he met Moore at a mobile home. During that sexual encounter, Henry Green walked into the trailer, took a shower, and joined in. The teen told investigators he didn't consent to sexual experience with the other man whom he'd recognized from the neighborhood. The teen told officers that he didn't say anything to either man about having sex with Henry Green. The relationship went on for 2 years until 2019. The teen admitted to having unprotected sex with both men during that time. However, according to the arrest report, the teen told investigators that 6 months into the relationship, he started having pain and developed sores where he couldn't sit down for long periods of time. He lost about 50 pounds and learned he tested positive for HIV. He told investigators he was sexually active in Belle Glade before the positive diagnosis for HIV and other venereal diseases. In a controlled phone call with authorities and the teen just this January, Green admitted Henry Green said that he had just learned about his HIV positive status. But according to the arrest report, Henry Green's medical record showed that he had been HIV positive since 2005. Wow. Also, when investigators questioned Vonkevious Moore, he denied knowing the teen and said he didn't have HIV. However, according to the investigators, Vonkevious Moore's health record showed that he has been HIV positive since 2014 and also contracted syphilis. Damn, they putting all their business out here. Vonkevious Moore also said he had known Henry Green for years. Wow. All right, y'all, let's go in. I don't know why y'all send me these stories. Y'all be like, Dawson, talk about it. We know you ain't gonna hold back, and you're right. I'm gonna say what I need to say. Let me say this. I don't know why these grown men and women cannot find people of their age, first of all. Leave these teenagers alone. I tell you all the time, no matter if we're talking about the little girls who are being bothered or the boys, that it doesn't matter if the teenager wants to participate in a sexual activity with you. The law is always going to look at you as the adult. I don't care if you all say that the girl was fast and she was fully developed or the boy looked like he was an NBA player or NFL. They don't care about that. The law is the law, and you as the adult, your face is always going to be blasted on the news, on newspapers, because you are the adult. It doesn't matter that they wanted it or they were on some social media app or some sex app or whatever. The law is always going to look at you as the adult. That goes for men and women. I say that all the time. Nobody believes me until your face is on the news and then you say, oh, well, she was fast. Oh, they wanted it. Why were they on an adult app? It don't matter. You got to do your due diligence and ask questions, ask to see their license instead of just trying to get off. Look here, let me say this also. You all know who've been watching my show. I tell you all, I have had family members and clients who passed away of AIDS-related complication. Actually, only one client and, you know, a couple family members have family members and friends and clients, many clients, who are HIV positive and are doing well. They're on their medication. So, you know, if you're out there and you're, oh, I don't know what to take your medication, go see a doctor. And if you don't want to go to the clinic in your neighborhood, go somewhere. Don't you sit there with this. You better go somewhere and get checked out, even if you got to go to the next county because you're, you know, afraid that somebody may see you and know your name. I've ran into many clients with that. Oh, everybody go to that clinic. Well, you better go on up there to Fort Lauderdale and go to their clinic. You better go on up there to West Palm if you don't want us to go to the ones in Miami. Like, for real, come on, y'all, go take care of your health. Like, honestly. So I don't want people to get so sensitive like, oh, Dawson, you don't know what you're talking about when you're talking about this. I know what I'm talking about because I work in the field. For these two men, Vonkevious Moore, 28 years old, and Henry Green, 43-year-old, for you all to do what you did to this young boy, he was 15 at the time you all started having sexual relationship with him, what you all have done is altered this boy's life because he's going to have to be on life-altering medication for the rest of his life. He's going to have to be on medication. And so many people will say you all have taken his life. I don't believe that. There are tons of people who are HIV positive, have herpes, have human papillomas virus and all that. They're living, even though they're living with, you know, a sexually transmitted disease. They're still out and living their life. There are people who are doing wonderful things. I don't think it's going to hold you back, but it has altered your life. So for you all to do that, knowing that you all had the virus and then lying to the boy saying that, you know, you didn't know you had it and all this kind of stuff, but when they pull up your medical records, the police said that, you know, Vonkevious Moore had it in 2014, and Henry Green here, 43 years old, he had it in 2005. So it's like, come on, man. If you all did that to this young boy, who else were you all in Belle Glades or Fort Lauderdale or Miami having sex with? I'm going to let y'all ponder that, because the people who sent me this story told me, and y'all better run to the clinics. Now, the individuals who sent me this story, they wanted me to know that this story is just not a story out of Belle Glades. That Mr. Vonkevious Moore, because they didn't know too much about Henry Green, but Vonkevious Moore, they said he traveled in South Florida. As a matter of fact, they said he is known for his, and this is allegedly because this is what they say, but they had documentation they wanted to send him for me to show, but I ain't putting that on my YouTube page. My subscribers are smart and you all can find it yourself. Allegedly, they said this man had house parties, sex parties throughout South Florida and probably Florida as well. And I was like, oh man, so you mean to tell me, you know that you have a life-altering virus and you are having house parties everywhere. And I know some people will say, because I said before, I was like, well, maybe, you know, if there are adults who are going there, then hopefully they're using protection. But I'm like, if this man is in jail now for having sex with a 15-year-old at that time, how do we know that teenagers weren't invited to those house parties that Mr. Vonkevious had throughout South Florida, allegedly? This is just a horrible story. It's a horrible story, but I must tell you all that it's not uncommon. When I worked at DCF, we had teenagers who were 14, 15, 16, 17. Some of them were HIV positive. Some of them had other incurable STDs, and they weren't born with it. You know, and some of them, we found that they were out doing things with adults. You know, people who wouldn't, you know, pillars of the community, messing with this little girl or messing with this little boy. You know, they come back to the foster home and, you know, they got new Jordans. Where you getting them Jordans for? Oh, man, you know, I've seen it all, y'all. These people will mess with these children. They will mess with these children. They do not care. You parents, I do these stories. You guardians, I do it for you all. Look out for your kids and especially the boys. You all keep neglecting the boys. I told you all before, it seems that they are after your boys. Y'all don't listen to me. And that's not only with this situation. Gay or straight, it's within. You got women out there doing the same thing, giving these little boys STDs. I done seen it all, man. Y'all, it is important. Look out for these kids. And you grown men, I don't care if you gay, straight, or whatever, same thing for the women. Find somebody your age. Why y'all want these little children? It's mind control. It's manipulation. Up here having sex with this 15-year-old boy who's now 17. Y'all, look out for these kids. This is a horrible, horrible, horrible story. But y'all know I'm going to talk about it because this is going on in our world. And we need to be aware of all of this. Now I'm off of this subject. You all go off in the comments. I'm going to leave the article in the description box below so you all can read up on this story. If you are a person who is HIV positive and you're not on your medication and you're not seeing a doctor, y'all go get on your medication. I have family members and friends, like I say, they're on their medication. They're doing fine. They're thriving. They are in relationships. They are living life. Don't you listen to these people who tell you, oh, you know, this happened to my cousin and that happened to my uncle and my brother had it. Look, that's your uncle, your cousin, and your brother. That ain't got nothing to do with me. That's what y'all got to tell them. That ain't got nothing to do with me. People come up in your face. Oh, you know what? My brother, he died of AIDS. Well, hell, tell them your brother died of AIDS. But damn it, if I keep trusting God, I'm going to get an endorsement with Gatorade. I'm going to live and not die. You got to fight. See, I'm from Florida. I got that Florida. Man, look here. Y'all better fight back. People walk all over you like a dog and give you their death sentence. You better get up and open your mouth and speak back. Shoot, I wouldn't have two platforms if I didn't speak back. That's why y'all here. Look here. So take y'all medication. Boy, I tell you, I wouldn't change nothing in the world. I love Florida. Florida done made me, Miami has made me tough. Now I'm bold as a rattlesnake. Look here. I'm out of here. I hope justice is served in this situation. You all take care of yourself and each other. Until next time, it's your guy Dawson. I love you all. Be safe.